Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello. So last video I posted was Demi Lovato's Substance music video reaction and post 48 views, which I am very appreciative of the 48 views. It then got blocked. So coming back in hot with the Pretty Reckless's Got So High music video. I mean, it's already pretty obvious what I'm going to be reacting to because it's already in the title, it's already made to a thumbnail, but still. For those who are actually visually impaired and watching this video, I do have on a blonde wig, blue eye contacts, somewhat the same makeup, shade wise, sort of, as Taylor in a reference photo that I have, a whitish top because she wears white at some point. And from what I can gather from the snippets of the music video, you know, she's lounging around everywhere, moving around slowly, a group of friends at a party, whether it was her hosted party or she just at one, and she took on some narcotics. But of course she had valid and justified reasons for why she was dabbling into opioids and stuff. She was in the raw of it as far as mental health goes, and left, right and center, a lot of her either idols or fans, or you know, artists she was a fan of and or direct friends, also in the music industry or in record deals, something like that. There's people passing away on her either suicide and or motorcycle accidents, and sorry, I'm getting notifications down here, and it is now 5 in the morning when I'm recording this. Hence a broad inspiration from her being on the Harley motorbike. I believe it's the full term of it. It's Harley Davidson, maybe? But it's definitely just a Harley motorbike, which is one of the covers from Just by Rock and Roll as a single song. One of the record producers, I can't remember the exact detail there, but the individual had gotten into a motorcycle accident and unfortunately succumbed to the injuries, meaning passed away from it. And then there was also, of course, the suicide of Chris Cornell. She was in a row of it, of people, of individuals she looked up to music-wise, and a really good friend of hers in the music industry, again, got into a horrible accident. So she was in a lot of pain from that, emotional pain, obviously. And ended up creating Death by Rock and Roll album just to express and really flush it out of her system, at least past the substance abuse and whatever else she was getting up to deal with the raw of it emotionally. So let's get on with this now. So far we have an eye and a woman dancing in the eye. Definitely different from the actual song in the album. But of course, with the music video, you get to be a lot more creative with the track. A lot more room to add sound effects or storylines and audios and such. That clearing throat at the beginning, I'm pretty sure it's also, there's a throat clearing noise followed by a coughish sound in my medicine. Turned out, wasted, confused, complacent, die. Lost my center, suppose I'm meant to hide. Even the hallway, she's, I mean, I'm sure she's actually already in the apartment complex, I think that might be. But even the hallway she's walking down is also very my medicine when she, you know, in silence and, you know, panda eye makeup, which was very OG Taylor Momsen when she was just getting into, you know, when Pretty Reckless was just getting into the fit of things, and the leather jacket that she wore. And she suddenly walked up to the door, through the hallway. You can hear her heels clicking. And there's already some similarities from My Medicine to Got So High. So we've gone from My Medicine, where she sings about how medication got mixed up, to in this one, very intentionally taking on narcotics. And similarities between My Medicine and Got So High. It's just as far as like Easter eggs type thing. So it's the clearing throat at the beginning. Then there's walking down the hallway, technically. In My Medicine, it was walking down the hallway, then clearing the throat when she starts to sing the song. But in this case, it's slightly reversed. So it's like similarities, but it just switched around a little bit just to switch up the perception of it. Whether or not that was their intention, that's just what I'm picking up. As for a polite gentleman. I have to say, even if it's not related at all, but with Taylor dancing under the light beam, laser beam, spotlight thingy right here, it reminds me so much of Monica Naranjo's Polvo Faccio, which is Empty Dust, well translated to Empty Dust, when she was singing in collaboration with Masadante, when they were dancing underneath that laser-like spotlight, dance light, whatever you want to call it. That from that Vizzy video just reminds me of what Taylor's dancing under, like I said, even if the two are not related. Unless it's about to change towards the very end, I'm just so surprised that nobody's naked this time, especially that one chick that was naked in My Medicine music video. Of course, I had to censor her in the actual music video, but when Taylor reposted it to Instagram, no censoring there. So, for whatever reason, they decided to change it up and limit the explicit nudity side of it. But of course, it could still change and someone could still pop up naked towards the end of this music video. But otherwise, so far, it's more just focusing on getting high substance abuse because of mental health and the raw of it, and not really immediately throwing yourself or pushing yourself specifically to getting some help and such. It's more looking for instant logical things, or what seems logical at the time. And it's getting high and just hanging out with a bunch of people who are already so high that really don't care if you're joining them to party. Or maybe she's got friends there. Between Taylor herself, especially if the party wise is actually a metaphor for a party she really did go to and whether or not she had mutual friends there, or if it was just a party she heard and decided to hop right into it. So whichever way that goes, this time it's more of just the emotional boundaries, not really paying attention to one another, just dancing to music, trying to enjoy the good life, what's left of it, and what there's room for. It's not so built heavily on explicitry and being reckless and throwing an orgy into a pile like this. It's just how she's how she was clearly very unhappy in depression, like what I said at the start of this video. It's not pushing know, being sexually reckless or sexually explicit and such, and just being randomly naked around people. It's more of a presentation of this Taylor at the time getting high was a cry for help. Of course, I cannot speak to her mental health. I have no idea what she went through. I have never endured the same losses she has had. But actions like these are genuinely a cry for help, even if there's no verbal cue to it. Let's finish the video now. Sweet. So again, definitely loving how it was very mellow. Love how the music video was like a very perfect fit, which is obviously the point of the actual song itself. It's very slow paced, and there was a bit of speed and drama to it, just as far as Taylor dancing under the laser spotlight thingy. It was just to give a bit of colour and a bit of drama, a bit of flair. But otherwise, with the party itself, you know, whatever consisted of that, mutual friends or just a whatever type of party invokes you to something like that. I don't know what I'm talking about because I've never been to a party like that. Nor have I, like I said, endured similar losses that Taylor has had. So this was my reaction to Prerequisites Got So High. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do hope you enjoyed this video, and I shall see you all for my future videos. Adios.